Dramatic dance stunts fill seats, an aim shared by West End impresarios and classical ballet companies alike. The result is pressure for ever more spectacular and physically taxing performances, and it seems more damaged dancers. Harley Street specialist Justin House reckons his patient list has increased by 25% in the last year. The dancers themselves don't complain.
A very subservient lot. People are, oh, they may never use me again or something like that. Not very often, no. You get the occasional militant one, but they're soon put down.
What happens in the end? I mean, you must just wreck yourself if you go on.
Well, yes, I've been off now since March, April, May, June, July, August, September. Yes, wrecks yourself for a couple of months until the next job.
Because the audiences ask for a lot more, and therefore as the shows are competing with each other and competing for audiences, they have to put on a spectacle. People want something that they can really see happening, something that looks dramatic. Also, of course, the choreographers, like all artists, musicians, singers, want to experiment and see how far they can go, what they can produce.
Well, you want to try and do something different, so you keep asking for more. There is a great danger to actually go too far, but you have to try and keep it back.
What about the sort of big spectacles like Starlight Express and so on? Are they making the audience expect more, do you think?
Yes, they do, because they go and see something like that, and of course they come to accept those things, and so therefore they want more and more and more. So it gets bigger and bigger and greater until who knows where it's going to end.
Well, where do you think it will and what's going to happen?
I don't know. Something's going to have to break.
At the moment, what's breaking is dancers' bones. The alternative, they say, is a break in the vicious circle of reduced arts financing, which leads to more commercial performances, which lead to injuries, which lead ultimately to lowered performances, reduced audiences, and more financial pressure. A dance, some say, to the music of our time. Rita Carter for Thames News.